Hey, this is DJ from DJ's Trains on YouTube, and we are in Newcastle, Pennsylvania, at the CSX yard. This is the east end of the yard, also called UN. If I was to do a really in-depth video, it would be an hour, 2 hours long. So I'm not going to do the whole yard. The middle has a bunch of tracks in it, same thing with the west end, but I'm just going to cover the east end. This is just to give you an idea of how yards look, how they work, maybe some dumb stuff that you can do just like the real railroads. So here, as we start coming down a little lower, this yard is pretty well lit. There are lights and also there are cameras. And why are there cameras? Because the yardmaster is 158 miles away. Yes, they moved the yardmaster out of Newcastle, and instead it's run from Willard, Ohio, and they keep an eye on us through cameras. Now, when you saw the opening shot, there was a single track. That is number 2 main, and here we see an eastbound coming down number 1 main. I'm going to pause the video. So that engine has just stopped with those cars on number 1 main. The main lines are controlled by the dispatcher. The dispatcher is in Jacksonville, Florida. The track to the left of it, you'll see those cars there, that we call the running track. Now, the switch leading to it is a hand-operated switch that the conductor can line only with permission of the dispatcher. Any tracks associated, connected to a main line, you need the dispatcher's permission. Now, the next track, we'll just say to the right of number 1 main, that is a siding. We just call that the siding track. That also is controlled by the dispatcher because it is signaled in and out. So permission onto a main line or a signaled siding is controlled by the dispatcher. Everything else is controlled by the yardmaster. Now, if I was to find you a map from 100 years ago, whenever this yard used to have, I think, humps and the track arrangements were different and tracks were closer together, they eliminated a lot of tracks, and it's stupid, but this track is actually called 1 and 4, and the next track is called 5 and 8. That's the truth. This is the dumb stuff. So as more tracks were eliminated, the next track with the engines that are detached from those cars, that track is called 9 and a half. And then the one next to it is number 13. And then those next two tracks are numbers 26 and 28. So I know you're going nuts. You're saying, man, why can't they just simplify this? You know, just number it like 1 through 7. I don't have that answer. This was probably just a software issue or something with the Yardmasters way back in the day. But that is how it looks in 2022. Now, look at 26, 28, 1 and 4 and 5 and 8. You will see a black drop cloth. That is because when our trains are parked there, it gives us an opportunity to fuel the engines. We use a fuel truck. They just come in and fuel the engines here. And if anything spills, they want it on that EPA drop cloth. Other things about this yard, number 28 track pretty much bypasses a lot of the shorter yard tracks that are on the west end that are out of view. 9 and a half and 13 meet together at a hand throw, but these tracks will eventually all lead onto the yard lead and then onto number 1 eventually. All right, so there you go. What's happening here is the eastbound train has those auto racks, and they're going to set some of these cars off. Number 1 main line is good for 20 miles per hour. Everything else is 10. Once again, yard tracks, any track other than main line tracks are usually 10 miles per hour. We can get off moving equipment now. There was like decades where we weren't allowed to, But now we can dismount from a moving engine at a speed of 4 miles per hour or less, which is what just happened there. And you can see the conductor getting off. And what he's going to do is he's going to count the cars as they go by, stop the train, and then he's going to apply handbrakes on the cars that he's leaving there. We test them for 1 minute, make sure nothing rolls. And if that's fine, then he'll get permission to go in between the cars, disconnect them, and then he'll need the signal off of number one main, and he'll set those cars off into this yard and then connect back onto his train, and then an outbound crew will take this train further east. If you've been following the Class 1 railroads for a while, you'll notice that most trains now have DP, or distributed power. That would be an engine in the middle or the rear of the train. And so you're not going to see all the engines at the front. Like we see, there's only one engine on the front. The new engines are powerful. No joke. So, yes, by using the DP and these bigger engines, we need less engines. From the ground, you really can't tell the amount of wear and tear and weathering on these engines. Look at the roof of that. It's showing some wear and tear there, huh? In this yard, we also interchange with the BP, the Buffalo and Pittsburgh. So you'll see some what we call the BP coal trains. And they also bring in some mixed freight on occasion. Let's see, if you're modeling, I've talked about this in my other yard videos. Now I have hundreds of videos. To see more about the yards, you'll look at the playlist for track planning. And there's a lot of yards I cover in that playlist. I've talked about this before, yards. The ballast is going to be different on a main line as opposed to a yard track. Now think about this. This conductor is going to be walking a lot. You don't want the high elevation of a main line. Yards are flat. Notice there's no real drainage here. So what we just saw as we're pulling back is that conductor, he tested the handbrakes. Nothing moved. We call it the 1 minute brake test. While we're getting ready for that engineer to start pulling, I'll show you a little bit more. Now notice there is a high signal right in front of that engine. That is still considered UN. That's a high signal. I can't really show it that well in this video, but the other tracks have little dwarf signals. They're old B&O dwarf signals. And that gives you permission onto the yard lead. Now the yard lead actually connects to what we call number three main. It's only a couple hundred yards long. But this area up here that I'm going to take you to is called P&W. I think that was the Pittsburgh and Western branch. The P&W is now the BP, the Buffalo and Pittsburgh Railroad, that branches off to the left and then goes that way. If we go straight on number one track, it'll eventually tie into we call West Pitt. And it will run parallel to number two main, which you see here to the right. I turned the camera around because now we have the crew is getting ready to shove two auto racks into the yard. A little bit about what's happening right here is the conductor is riding the point, as we call it, the point. He has to protect his shoves at all times. So he is riding the engineer side, and the engineer can probably see him pretty good. We can go by hand signals if we can see each other clearly. If we can't, we use the radio. So he probably got on the radio, and if he's going to say something on the radio, he's going to say, we have the restricting signal at UN. And then the engineer will shove those two cars. It looks like those are going to go into tracks 1 and 4. Coupling speed is 4 miles per hour or less, but the drone battery was getting a little bit low, so I didn't film all of that. But that's just a gist of yards. Hopefully this gave you some great information and more after this quick little break. Hey, you want to see something cool? Well, not cool anymore. This was a coal-fired power plant. It is natural gas. It's been converted a long time ago. But way, way, way back in the day, this was served by the railroad. Those tracks have been ripped up for decades now. But this is a power plant that you can model something like this. Not that hard. Try your hand at scratch building. If you are modeling N scale, go with an HO or an O scale smokestack. Yeah, pretty cool modeling idea. The electrical stuff, you can get those from Kato and Atomics. So add a power plant. Make it served by rail. Be a lot of fun. I ask that you subscribe to my channel, DJ's Trains. One of the very few people that teach you exactly how the railroad works from an engineer's point of view. Hundreds of videos on my channel, all organized into playlists so you could find anything easy. Be sure to subscribe and like and comment and share my videos. You can follow me on Facebook and Twitter and Instagram under DJ's Trains. My website, djstrains.com. The Patreon site, which is awesome because you get footage that no one else gets to see. And a chance to maybe do Zoom calls. And I've even done some live chats with just a Patreon. So that's a cool thing for you to check out. Help support this channel. Did so much traveling because I got even more videos. Really cool stuff from Canada and all over. So subscribe and I'll see you in the next video very soon. Bye.